In the previous video, we have seen part 1 interview questions on Java data types. So, this is completed now. In this video, we will be seeing some more interview questions, which is part 2 interview questions on Java data types. Okay, the first question is, what is primitive casting in Java? Primitive casting in Java. So, what is primitive casting in Java? Primitive casting is used to convert primitive values from one data type to another data type. We have different data types like byte, short, int, long. So, like this, we have different data types. And byte takes 1 byte, short takes 2 bytes, int takes 4 bytes, and long takes 8 bytes. So, primitive casting is converting one data type variable to another data type variable. That means if we want to convert a byte type variable to a short type variable, or if we want to convert an int type variable to a short type variable, this is called primitive casting. And there are two kinds of casting in Java. One is implicit casting. Second one is explicit casting. So, what is implicit casting? In implicit casting, the conversion happens automatically. That means, if we want to convert a byte type variable to a short type variable, we don't need a casting here, because here the conversion happens automatically. The reason is, short is a larger data type than byte, because short takes 2 bytes while byte takes 1 byte. So, we can convert a byte type variable to a short type variable directly without any casting, and this is called implicit casting. Explicit casting. If we want to convert an integer to a short, or if we want to convert an integer to a byte type variable, then casting is needed. The reason is, integer is a larger data type value than short or byte. So, casting is needed for this one. And this is called explicit casting. So, what is primitive casting? Primitive casting is used to convert primitive values from one data type to another. For example, an int value can be assigned to a float data type, or a double value can be assigned to an int data type. Casting can be either implicit or explicit. Implicit casting, we don't need casting here, specific casting. The conversion happens automatically. Implicit casting happens when you convert or assign a smaller value like a byte to a larger value such as an int. Explicit casting, for explicit casting, we need casting to be done. That means we have to explicitly do the casting. In explicit casting, code has to be specifically written to perform the conversion of one primitive type to another. Explicit casting is done by using the syntax. So, we use this particular syntax. We use brackets here and we specify the Java type, data type, where the data type is the data type that the cast is being applied to. Explicit casting happens when you convert or assign a larger value to a smaller value. Okay, next question is, what are the default values of primitive data types? The default values of primitive data types, they are depending on where they are declared. For example, let's say I have a class here, which is class some primitive values. So, this is a class I have. And I have a method here, let's say public void display, and this is the method I have. Let's say I am declaring the variables here, that means either they are class variables or instance variables. So, if I say static int a, I am not assigning any values to these variables, I am just declaring them. So, static int b. So these are two class variables, and int c, int d, these are the instance variables. So these are class variables and these are instance variables. Let's say I declare some local variables here, which is int e, int f, and I am writing a for loop here for int I is equal to 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus, and within this I am declaring some more variables which are block variables, int g, int h. So these are local variables and these are block variables. Okay, now I have declared these variables, but I haven't initialized them, any of these variables. That means I haven't assigned any values for these variables. So what happens in this case? For class variables or instance variables, these variables will be initialized to their default values. But these variables, they won't be initialized to their default values. So no initial values. So let's see once again. The default values of the variables, they depend on where they are exactly defined in a class. If we define the variables as static, that means class variables, or instance variables, then those variables will be initialized to their default values. If we define the variables as local variables or block variables, then they won't be initialized to their default values. We have to initialize these variables which are declared as local or block variables before we use them. So let's see an example for this. I'm creating a new class here, new class, default values. I'm using main method here, and I am creating some class variables here, which is static byte b, static short s, static int I, static long l, static float f, static double d, static boolean bo, static char ch. So these are the class variables I have declared here. Now I will print these class variables. Sysout byte b value is plus b. And the next one is short s, value is s, I, l, f, d, b, o, c, h. Int I value is, long l value is, float f value is, double d value is, boolean bo value is, char ch value is. Okay, so we have declared some class variables here and we haven't initialized any of these variables and we are trying to print those values and let's see what these values will be. So I am running this program. Here you can see byte b value is 0, short s value is 0, int I value is 0, long l value is 0, float f value is 0.0, double D value is 0.0, boolean VO value is false, and char ch value is nothing, that means it is null. Since these are class variables, the variables are initialized to their default values. Similarly, for instance variables also, the instance variables will be initialized to their default values. Let's say if I define these values here. So here I am saying byte b short s I am commenting this one int I long l float f double d boolean vo char ch. Let's say I define the variables as block variables or local variables, and you can see that all these statements are erroring out because we haven't initialized them. The error is the local variable may not have been initialized. That means what it is saying is initialize these variables before using them. That means if there are local variables or block variables, we have to initialize them before using them. If these are class variables or instance variables, they will be initialized to their default values. Next question is, how is rounding performed under integer division? Let's say we have two integers. One is int a is equal to 5 and another one is int b is equal to, let's say, 2. Now, if we divide these two, the actual result should be 5 by 2, which is 2.5. But since these are integer, if we assign this value to another integer like c, then this fractional part will be truncated and only 2 will be assigned to c. Let us see an example on this one. I am creating a new class here, which is class integer division, and I am using this main method here. So what I am doing here is I am creating two integer variables, int a equals to 5, int b equals to 2. I am creating another integer variable, which is int c equals to a divided by b. So now let us print the value of c. Sysout value of c is plus c. And if we run this program now, the value of c is 2. That means the fractional part is truncated and that value is assigned to the variable c. So how is rounding performed under integer division? The fractional part of the result is truncated. This is also known as rounding towards 0. Next one is, can you compare a boolean with an integer variable? No, we cannot compare them. We will get a compilation error. What is the output of the following? System.out.println 1.0/0. If we have something like 1 divided by 0, this is an integer. This 1 is an integer here. So if we have this one, this gives an arithmetic exception. Integers division with 0 are not accepted in Java and it throws arithmetic exception. But if we have a double value, this is a double value. So if we have a double value divided by 0, then this gives infinity. It won't throw any exception, and double values division by 0 are allowed in Java and they give the result as infinity. Let us see this example. I am creating a new class here, which is division by 0, and I am using the main method. So here what I am doing is, I am just printing sysout and 1 by 0. That's what I am doing. When I run this program, since we are dividing an integer by 0, it should throw an error. an exception, and the exception is arithmetic exception. But if we use 1.0, which is a double value by 0, and if we run it again, save it, see, it is showing as infinity. That means infinity value is supported by double values in Java. Okay, now we have completed part 2, interview questions on Java data types. You can download this document from my GitHub repository, which is at github.com/supostech, and go to Selenium Java tutorials. This document starts with 4b, so search with 4b and you will see it here, Selenium Java data types interview questions part 2, and you can download this document. In the next video we will see Java operators, what are the different operators that we have, and also arithmetic operators and assignment operators.